What is your say about this election results of the five states?
It is people's verdict. People are supreme. India is a democratic country. And we have seen big stalwarts losing elections. Big time politicians in Goa also losing elections. Because people are supreme and people decide. The minute you are not in connect with the people, people decide your fate. If you lose your grassroots level connection, if you're not there with the people, then people decide that you should be out. Even the policies of GST, I think, has hit the people, especially the common man, in a big way. Also, RERA, where small-time builders were there, have stopped the construction business, and lot of civil engineers, supervisors, clerical staff, and all those other people are jobless today. So that industry is very big. The labor force, the masons, the helpers, they are all left behind, and they are waiting for the jobs to start back again. Waiting for the.
What effect it can have in Goa as far as another 3 months Lok Sabha elections are there? Two MPs of your party.
First important thing, the economy of the state is paralyzed because of mining, and I am on record that mining has to resume. By merely going to Delhi is not going to solve the problem. The central government has in its command, they are the decision making body, whether to amend or they have to say at least, okay, you go as per our national policy, that is option. They have, somebody has to say it. Nobody is saying it. If we had to work on the national policy, the day mining stopped in Goa, today mining would have resumed on auction. Now, nobody is saying whether it is auction or whether it is amendment to the existing act.
Okay.
MMDR Act will be amended. Somebody has to say it. Nobody is saying. So everybody is looking at one another's face. Who is going to say this? Who is going to say this? It's a responsible person. That is the chief minister of the state of Goa. Or the mining minister of India. The cabinet minister. Or the prime minister. These are the three people who can speak on this.
You think, sir, everybody has failed in this issue?
It's not a question of failure. It is the Supreme Court who has stopped mining in Goa. They have stopped because the national policy on mining is auction. Whether Goa is a special case, because we were ruled by the Portuguese, the leases were there before the Portuguese rule. So they were continued, and finally now again they were continued and signed by Honorable Ex-Chief Minister Sri Lakshmikant Parsikar. So now, all these things are happening from the Portuguese era. Goa was liberated much after 1947. So, taking into account all these things, something can be done and worked out for amendment in MDR Act, but it has been too long.
Correct.
The wait, the patience, everything is over. So, it is now nearly one long year. Going to complete one long year for the mining that it has stopped.
If mining issue is not resolved, it can have an effect on Lok Sabha elections?
That is surely, you know. Mining resolved means what? We have to see what the central government has to say on this. It is in their court. Whether they say we are amending the MMDR Act by issuing ordinance. Now already the session has started. They can introduce it in the session and pass it. whether they are going to do that or they are going to go as per their policy. Their policy is optional.
Parliament has already started, so is still the time there to put up this before the parliament, because it has to be done before.
It is the Prime Minister of the country who can do it. He is the decision making
authority.
He is the person who can do it. So I am requesting him, as one of his very, very small, tiny state, a dot in the map of India, his MLA. I am there with his party for the last 14 years. I am requesting him, on behalf of the people of Goa, on behalf of the economy of the state, on behalf of all the poor people who are working in this sector, that he needs to come out very clear on this. Because lot of time has passed and we are waiting for results. And I think 6 months back, this thing should have been resolved. And it has gone too far now, and it has gone at the fag end of the term. So he still has an opportunity and chance to amend the act and give relief to the people of Goa.
Sir, last, yesterday Babu Asgaon, the tourism minister, said that EDM proposal, if it comes, then it could be held in the month of February, not in during Christmas. What is your say? Because EDMs mostly would be held in your constituency.
See, I do not want to comment on this. Festivals should be listed on the calendar of the tourism. So today, the tourism in Goa is not planned the way it should have been planned. And it will take some time to bring in reforms in tourism. And if you look at the tourist who is coming in Goa, the quality of tourist is just gone down to shambles. Reforms will come, and I think people of Goa will give me that opportunity to bring the necessary reforms in the near future.
By becoming a minister?
No, by becoming minister you cannot bring the reforms. My thing is, I want to become the chief minister of the state to bring the reforms in education, reforms in tourism sector, reforms in mining has to be properly done, properly planned for the state of Goa, looking into account the people who are there, especially the people from this mining sector. Tinka kon vishwasan ghet na kire korta na. 2012 mukhyamantri unala mining suspend kariya. Tinka isalla. Ho maza prashna. Did he ask those people what is going to be their faith? Did he know that he's my leader? But again, today, on his birthday, I am cautioning this. From that time, this problem has started. So, if people of Goa give me the opportunity to head the state, I will bring the necessary reforms for the people. I will see that the poorest and the poor person will benefit from different types of economies of the state. Mining is first, tourism is second, pharmaceutical companies, industry. All these places require major touches. It is just not that a person is sitting and saying that I am the minister of this or I am the chairman of this. You have to bring in new changes. Goa is changing. You look at the profile of tourists who are coming into Goa. It's going bad to us. So I am not putting the onus on Babu Asgaonkar, because he's become minister now. I am blaming all the ex-ministers who have neglected the state of Goa to bring in the reforms in the tourism sector, to bring in the necessary changes in the tourism sector. That is why we are suffering today. Mining has stopped because of the wrong decisions taken by some leaders. I will not name them. So, if leaders take wrong decisions, if leaders are not interested in the people of the state, if they are only interested in their self-gain, how will the people of the state be happy? They will be jobless all the time. They will be waiting for jobs. So we have to collectively work for the people of Goa, because they are the people who elect us and we are responsible for them.
Thank you, sir.